A very good day to all of you.
Computer Shiksha is supported by.
In the previous class, you learned about command, which is very important. You will be using these commands in the future also. When we work in an office, or even if we make a file at home, then we need to make use of these commands every day. In the further classes, you can make use of commands to make pictures. All of you, now power on your computer and open the paint file. In today's class, we will learn about the Polygon tool. And we will get to know about what is the Polygon tool. We will also use the Polygon tool to make many drawings like the Taj, table lamp, tree, etc. Let us now learn about the Polygon tool. Can you tell what is the Polygon tool? The Polygon tool functions like the line tool. However, with the line tool, you can draw any type of line anywhere. But when you use the Polygon tool and draw, then you have to make sure that the starting point and the end point are the same. With the help of the Polygon tool, can you all make a box? If yes, then all of you look at the picture being shown to you and make a box using the Polygon tool. If you face any difficulty in making this, then watch and learn from the video. Let us now watch in this video how we can use the Polygon tool to make a rectangular box. So to use the Polygon tool, first go to the Shapes menu and click on the Polygon tool. Once you have selected the Polygon tool, bring your pointer to the paint sheet and drag a line from a point where you want to draw the box. Next, once you have drawn the first line, all you have to do is click at the place where you want the second line to be made, and the second line will automatically get dragged. So this is the advantage of the Polygon tool. Now for the third line, again we click at this point and a third line gets dragged. And then for the final line, we just click on the starting point and the polygon or the rectangular box gets made. So this is the advantage with the Polygon tool, and this is how you can use the Polygon tool to draw a rectangular box. Can you all tell what is this picture called? This is a picture of a crown worn by kings and queens. By looking at this picture, can you say how many polygons have been connected in it? In this picture, 8 polygons or lines have been connected. Can you all make this picture? If you have any doubt while making this picture, then you should watch the video and learn to make the picture from the video. With the help of this video, let us now see how we can use the Polygon tool to make this picture of a crown. For this, first select the Polygon tool by clicking on the polygon in the shapes. Bring your pointer into the paint sheet and drag the first line like this, as is being shown in the video. Next, you just have to take the pointer to a point here and click there, and the second line automatically gets dragged. Take the pointer to the third point, the third line gets dragged. Bring the pointer up here, like this. Click here and you'll see the fourth line come. So with the polygon tool, all you have to do is take your pointer to where you want to drag the next line, click there, as is being shown in the video, and the lines automatically get dragged. Bring it here, click here, and the seventh line comes here. In the last case, just remember that you have to end the polygon from where you had started and click on that point. So the drawing of the crown is complete. Now to fill color in it, just select the fill in color option and then select the color that you want to fill. We have selected yellow as color 1. And then take your pointer inside the crown, click there, and the color will get filled within the crown. Remember that if the lines are not joined correctly, or if you click outside, then the color will spread all over your paint sheet. So take care of that. Next, you all have to make the picture of a tree. Can you all make this picture by yourself or not? If not, then let us watch this video and learn to make this picture. By watching this video, let us now see how we use the polygon tool to make a nice Christmas tree. So first select the polygon tool. Choose color 1 as black. Bring your pointer to the drawing area and then drag the first line like this. Take the pointer towards the right side and just click here. The second line will automatically get dragged. Again, take the pointer here, just below the area there. Click there and the next line gets dragged. Again, take the pointer to the right side. Since you have already seen the picture of the tree, you know what you are trying to draw. Bring the pointer here, left click on it, and the line gets automatically dragged. Again, take the pointer to the right side, click there. Next line, we want a vertical line for the trunk of the tree. So we just drag it here, just click there, and the next lines get dragged automatically. So you can see, now you have to draw the right side of the tree. So bring the pointer to the right, click there, the line gets dragged. Bring the pointer here, left click on it, and the line gets dragged automatically. Again, go to the right side, click there, remember you are using left click, and the line gets dragged automatically here. Again on the right side, position the pointer and left click on it, the line comes automatically by getting dragged. Now the last point is the beginning point of the polygon, so remember that. Click there and your tree is complete. Now to fill it with color, just choose the fill with color option from here, left click on it, and then select the color 1 as green. Now bring your pointer to inside the tree, inside that polygon, and then click on it to fill it with green color. So this is how you can make the tree. Remember, if you had any gaps in this polygon or any gaps in the lines of the trees, your whole paint sheet would have been colored with green. So take care of that. The next picture is of a lamb. Can you tell, in order to make this picture of a lamb, which all tools we need to use. In order to make this picture of a lamp, you will need to use the line tool along with the polygon tool. Then you will need to use the text tool to type the name of the lamp and use the fill with color option to fill colors inside the lamp. Can you all make this picture or not? If not, then you need to take help by watching the video. Let us now watch this video and see how we can use the polygon, line tool and other tools to make the picture of a lamp. So first we need to select the polygon tool by clicking on the polygon shape. Select color one, whatever you like. We've selected green. Bring the pointer into the paint sheet and drag the first line of the polygon like this. Then now you know the next line you have to just click with the pointer till where you want to draw the line, and the second line automatically gets dragged on its own. Take the pointer here, third line by clicking, take it here, the fourth line, and then remember to close the polygon by clicking on the starting point. So the fifth line gets dragged and the polygon is complete. So this is the first polygon. Now we are drawing a second polygon as the stand of the lamp. So we just drag a line as is being shown. The second line of the second polygon, we just need to click on the pointer, left click, and the second line is automatically dragged. Bring it up to this point. Click here and the third line gets automatically dragged. Now remember that you have to close this polygon. So from this point, click on the first point of the second polygon so that the polygon is completed. Because otherwise, if the polygon is not completed, if there is a gap in the lines, the color will spread out. Now we are making a third polygon as the base of the lamp. So we first drag a line like this, then next line we just have to click, also the next line we have to just click, and the second and the third line of the third polygon are dragged automatically. Now again close the third polygon also by clicking on the starting point of the third polygon, and here you can make a wire by just dragging one line. You can use the polygon tool. You can also use the line tool to draw this. Next, we want to fill in the colors. So choose the fill in color option and then select the color that you like. For instance, we have taken dark blue. Click inside the lamp and that color comes. Now if you want, you can change the color one, to put the color in the stand. We are choosing brown, and click inside the second and the third polygon to fill in that color. Rays of light. So we need to use the line tool. So we select the line tool. Select the color one as black and then just draw these lines here like this to make the rays of the light. So this is how you are making the rays of the light coming out from the lamp, and you can draw this beautiful picture of the lamp. You can adjust these rays the way you like them. Like this. Now we have to write the word lamp by using the text. Then you will need to use the text tool to type the name of the lamp and write LAMP with our keyboard. Now You will all make the last picture for this class, and the same is being shown to you. After making this picture, show it to your teacher. Again, if you face a problem in making this picture, then watch the video and learn from it. With the help of this video, let us learn how we can make this colorful picture. So for this, first you need to select the polygon tool. Bring your pointer to the drawing area and drag a line as is being shown. Take the pointer on this side up here. Click here. So the second line gets dragged automatically, and then just close the polygon by clicking on the starting point. So the first polygon is ready. Next, take the pointer here just below the first polygon and then drag a line here which will form a part of the second polygon. Like this. Click here so that the second line is dragged automatically. Click on a little side here and then close this polygon by clicking on the starting point. And you can see that the polygon closes by itself. The second polygon is ready. We are dragging a third line to form the third polygon. Click down below here so that the line gets dragged automatically. Click on a side here to make another line automatically dragged. So now you can watch the video and follow the drawing being made and make your own drawing also. You can continue to watch the video. After drawing, dragging automatic lines, the last line is at the, we click on the starting point of the polygon so that the polygon gets closed by the last line which is automatically dragged. So we've already made three polygons. We are making a fourth polygon by dragging a line. Click here and you have a long line. Click here, up here, a small line here, like this. Another line comes here. Bring it downwards and then close the polygon. So one more polygon is ready. Again, we take our pointer to the place where we want to draw the next polygon. Drag one line from here downwards. Then click here so that the second line gets automatically dragged. Go up here, click, then the third line gets automatically dragged, small fourth line, fifth line. So you can see as is being shown in the video, and then in the end, we click on the starting point of the polygon that we were making so that the polygon gets closed automatically. Now we are drawing the next polygon from here up here, and we draw a line downwards by dragging. This is the next polygon that we are making. Now for the other sides, we just have to keep clicking and our lines will get automatically dragged, as you already know. Click here like this. Then you can join the starting point and this polygon is also ready. So you already have 6 polygons in this picture. So we will continue like this, draw more polygons to fill the picture, draw a line like this, slanted line. Then from here, you can just take the pointer to the place where you want the next line, left click on that, and a line gets automatically dragged till that point. As you can see in the video, go down again and the third line gets dragged for this polygon. Next is the fourth line. So like this we continue and make a slightly bigger polygon this time. Now go upwards. Click here, the line gets automatically dragged, and then we click on the starting point to close this polygon also. Let's continue like this to make a few more polygons. So you can click here, drag a line like this, go up here, second line is automatically dragged, and then we close this polygon by clicking on the starting point. But since we wanted a different polygon, not a triangle, what we are going to do is we are going to select this and use the delete key to delete this polygon which we had just made. So we will make another polygon here instead of the triangle. Drag this line, click on this side to make the second line by automatically being dragged, a third line, a fourth line, and then we close this polygon. So it has 5 sides in this polygon that we have drawn. Now we are drawing another polygon here. We are trying to fill the entire rectangular area of our drawing with different polygons inside it, and then we will color them. So we are just clicking and lines getting automatically dragged. In the end, we click on the starting point so that the starting point and the end point of the polygon are the same. So we're drawing another polygon here. If you look carefully, it looks like a tie. So we're drawing it here, taking it a small line downwards, then taking it upwards again. And then finally, we will join the starting point and the end point to make this polygon also. One more polygon in this area. Start from here and draw a line like this, downwards, slanted. Take your pointer here, click here to automatically drag the second line, then drag the third line automatically and close the polygon. Let's draw one more polygon on the top here. A small line here, another small line here, another small line here, here, bring it up here, and then let's close this polygon. So we have drawn many polygons now. We need just one or two more, and then this area would be fully covered by this rectangular picture which has many polygons inside it. And then we will use multiple colors to make the colorful picture. So we're dragging by just placing the pointer and clicking left click, and the polygon continues. Click here and then close the polygon. One more polygon here on the top right side of the rectangular area, or here, let's make it here like this. Make a small line, continue the polygon here. So by making this picture, you are practicing making many polygons within a given area. And your drawing obviously will improve with practice. Now we are taking the pointer to the fill with color option and select a color as color 1 and then click inside the polygons to fill them with the blue color. Next, change the color to yellow and fill the yellow color also in a polygon. Change the color to dark blue, fill it here in this polygon. We can take a pointer to any other polygon or change the color like this. Purple color we have filled here. Change the color once more to dark blue, fill it in this polygon. Here also, and here, and here, and here. So we have made many polygons with this dark blue color. We change the color once again to purple. Then we have changed the color to green. So we have filled up the color. The last color we have selected yellow, dark, bright yellow, and we have filled up here. So this way, you can make the polygons and fill them up with colors of your choice. Now, all of you need to save your file and properly shut down your system. In today's class, all of you learned about the polygon tool, and with the help of the polygon tool, you also made some pictures like box, crown, tree, etc.
Computer Shiksha is supported by.
Thank you.